Welcome to NRF Foundation All Access. I'm Roopal Patel, the Senior Vice President and Fashion Director of Saks Fifth Avenue. I'm excited to be here for 20 questions. This is all focused on what you want to know about the retail industry. We've gathered a great list of your questions. Let's get started. What was your journey to get to the role you're currently in? I've worked in luxury retail for over 20 years. I began my career in specialty stores and went to start my own luxury consulting company. 5.5 years ago, Mark Metrick, the president and CEO of Saks, reached out to me to offer me my current position. What did you do in college to help you get to where you are today? You know, I didn't go to school for fashion. When I went to NYU, I went to study law, and halfway through, probably about my sophomore year, I decided I wanted to be in fashion. I've always loved fashion since I was a little girl, and I had no idea you could pursue a career in fashion. I started taking odd jobs at the local Urban Outfitters and having internships throughout the, you know, throughout my career, or my education, I should say, and really came to this place of being like, I want to be in this industry. It was in the 90s, so being in fashion, like, it wasn't like it is today. You kind of had to forge your own path and find your own way. What does your day-to-day job look like? I don't have the typical, this is what my day looks like. In my career as fashion director, or as my job as fashion director at Saks Fifth Avenue, no day is ever the same. No week is ever the same. For example, this week we are in back-to-back pre-spring 2022 appointments and collection overviews. And next week, we're going to start gearing up for our holiday campaigns and picking all the fashion for that. It's always an adventure. Every day always brings its own set of surprises. And that's what I think I love so much about the role. What are your biggest goals in your role? I think the most important thing in my role as fashion director is to make sure that Saks is leading and really making sure that we are the fashion authority, whether that's day to day, season to season, month to month. Fashion is always changing, and it's important that we are on the pulse of it for our customers. So I think being a fashion authority and making sure that our customers have access to the best of the best fashion, the best of the best designers out there, is something that is always top of mind and keeps me on my toes. What is the most exciting part of your job? It's getting to see the fashion every single day. I love that I get to see beauty, you know, at every single collection I see, that I get to meet the designers and the creative minds behind all of this. It's so stimulating to talk with other creatives and to just see this next generation of talent that's blossoming and growing. And that really brings me so much satisfaction. I think just, you know, meet a designer for the first time in their showroom and seeing their first collection, and then seeing it, you know, on Saks.com, or seeing one of our Saks customers wearing, you know, the designer's piece for the first time. I love that. Like, that's the best part of my job. What excites you about retail, and why is this the industry you picked for your career? I've always loved retail. My parents used to take us, you know, to the stores and shopping and to the mall as like an activity on Thursday nights. And I was mesmerized. I was mesmerized by the windows, by the mannequins, by the, you know, the clothes. I would touch them, I would feel them. And I think when I think of retail, it's about an experience. You know, retail really is all about the senses. It's about sight, sound, smell, taste. I mean, you name it. It really is about that overall experience. And I think that's something that we're all looking for these days, is something, you know, that experience. And it's really where clothing comes to life on so many different ways. You can escape into someone else's world for a minute or 5 minutes or even the whole day. How did you find your niche in the industry? You know, it's interesting when you think of fashion director, people still ask me like, well, what does a fashion director do? These jobs, the idea of a fashion director, I had no idea what it was. And I was an assistant in the fashion office at Bergdorf Goodman. And that's when I realized I wanted to be a fashion director, wanted to be, you know, in a job that allowed me to have access to all the designers, to all the creativity, allow me to stay on the pulse of trends on what's new, what's relevant, what's coming up. And I think what's so interesting about, like, the role of fashion director, it's so molded and blended into like what's happening in the world, right? So to be able to connect fashion and cultural events and how it translates, I think. So it's a niche role in itself. I'm lucky that I stumbled upon it. And I really love what I do. In your role as fashion director for Saks, where do you find your inspiration? I think inspiration comes from so many different resources. It's not just on the runway, or it's not just from clothing. When I go out, you know, I live in New York City. When I go out on the streets, I see so many, you know, what people are wearing, how they're wearing it, how they're putting it together. When I travel, I find so much inspiration from travel. It's about everything that's happening around you, whether it's from art, whether it's from literature, music, cultural references. I think I'm always inspired by something I see or something I feel in the air. So it's I'm always looking at different ways, again, to like stay inspired. And I think being in New York City is a great asset to that. How do you stay updated on fashion trends? I have to say, you know, the pandemic and lockdown really shifted how we stay current on fashion trends, and social media has been such a saving grace. I can't say enough about Instagram and just all of the virtual access that we're having. So I think that's been really important lately. But I also think, again, like going back to like being inspired, whether it's what's happening in our current world and that's how that's affecting the designers' mindsets, or you know, really taking a look at what's happening around you is another way that, you know, having more access to fashion and trends. What are the trends you're expecting to see in 2021 and beyond? Well, for 2021, you know, it's been a season that is coming out of lockdown and it's post-pandemic, and we're seeing a lot of what we're calling like cozy dressing, a lot of different takes on knitwear, this idea of being protected and covered and cocooned. So a lot of great statement outerwear, puffers, capes, puffchos, parkas, you name it. A lot of head-to-toe knitwear, whether it's a knit dress, a cozy knit sweater, full-on knit ensemble. You know, there's a wide range of trends that we are seeing, which has been really incredible to see. But it's interesting, as we're in pre-spring market right now, we're starting to see everything from ball gowns to fancy high heels, Cinderella shoes, you know, to a lot of green. Green is everywhere, a lot of pastels, and just a lot of like back to life, happy clothes. In what ways do you believe COVID has permanently changed fashion? I mean, I think COVID has changed, obviously changed the way we work, from going to shows in person to seeing, you know, full-on fashion weeks virtually. It pared things down. I think it really made us focus on what is really important, and that's the clothing at the end of the day, and that's the designer's vision without all of the pomp and the circumstance that you're seeing out there. I think it just brought it back to basics, and at the end of the day, we are a billion-dollar business, you know, billion-dollar business and industry, so it is about the clothes. But I think the part that we all miss so much is, you know, this is the what you get from when you're at, you know, a fashion week or shows, or you're interacting with the designer and in their environment. So what I'm really excited about is returning to collections, returning to showrooms, returning to meeting with the designers, you know, really bringing our designer community together again and moving forward. When you look at what's ahead in the coming months, what are you most looking forward to? Well, New York Fashion Week is back, and that's happening in September, so I'm super psyched about that. Fingers crossed that Milan and Paris are happening. I'm just excited to see fashion up close and personal. I had my first market appointment in person the other day at Carolina Herrera, and it was just so wonderful to see the clothing in person. What does Saks have coming up that you're excited about? Saks has a lot coming up. I think that's the beauty of this company. We're always moving forward. We're always moving ahead and thinking ahead. What we have planned right now, Saks.com, we're really focusing on our growth and bringing you the best of the best product and designers on Saks.com. We're all gearing up for the launch of fall collections here at Saks that will be coming in the month of July and August. Obviously, New York Fashion Week is very important to us, so we are getting ready to kick off New York Fashion Week and celebrate American fashion here at Saks in the month of September. And then we're already working on holiday. So that is coming. The team is really putting together our holiday offering, and stay tuned. As you know, if you've been to New York City in the month of November, you know that the Saks holiday window unveiling is one of the most anticipated events of the year. And we are looking forward to that always. It's very magical and very special here at Saks. What experiences have made the biggest impact on your career? I think one of the biggest things that happened was when I launched my own consulting company prior to joining Saks. It was such a moment for me to kind of jump off the cliff, think outside of the box, and really not know where I was going to land. And it was incredibly liberating. I think I was challenged to think in so many different ways, on so many different levels that were new to me. And I think really that experience has helped bring me into my experience at Saks and into my role. I worked with companies such as Farfetch, Loewe, Jour, Roxana Ilinchik, W Hotels, CFDA, to name a few. And I feel like that was just a very unique time in my life. And I'm really grateful that I had that. What accomplishments are you most proud of? I think this year has really made me reflect a lot on my career and the responsibility I have being a woman of Indian descent and being a woman of color. I'm incredibly proud to have achieved all I've achieved in my career, but I think one of the things that means the most to me is being, you know, a woman of color at a senior level position. It's not why I got into fashion. It's something I never thought I would achieve. But now being in this position, I think it's incredibly important to be able to pay it forward and be a role model and help to mentor, nurture, and develop the next generation of talent, especially women of color. That's something that I think is probably one of the things I aspire to most on a day-to-day basis. And yeah, there's a lot that we need to do. What is something you learned early on that has carried with you into today? Someone once told me that change is constant. And I think that at the time I didn't really understand what that meant, because I'm such a creature of habit and I'm a Capricorn, so I like things to be very systematic and set in a certain way. And when things change, it's very surprising. But I think that really stuck with me. And it's something I've really embraced as almost a mantra, that change, you know, change is constant and it's happening. And that's a good thing. Like, things should be changing. That means things are moving forward. That means things are progressing. That means that things are in flow. So that's something for me that I think is like, change is constant. And I think that actually really helped in the last 18 months, that when everyone comes to me like, what's going on? How are you? I'm like, one day at a time. And things, as we've learned, things change daily. So now when something changes, I'm not so surprised. You just go with the flow and you make the best that you can. You do what you can to make it the best. How do you know when to turn off work? I have very strong boundaries when it comes to work-life balance. And that's something I had to teach myself. That's something I had to learn. When I first started and when I was first in the industry, it was like work can be 24/7 if you let it. And I realized it wasn't very healthy and I wasn't allowing myself enough time. So I have very clear boundaries. I work hard. I play hard. When I come into the office, I want to be very focused. I want to deliver and I want to make sure I'm taking care of what I need to take care of. But when I go home, I switch off. And anyone who knows me knows that I am not looking at my phone at 6:30. I'm not looking at my phone at 7 a.m. I will start answering emails at 8:30 a.m. So yeah, I think it's really important that you have clear boundaries on work-life for a better work-life balance. What is one misconception about retail that you would love to debunk for everyone? That retail is dead. It really, really bothers me when people say that retail is dead. It's like, people are still shopping, right? People still need that little bit of joy and that experience, I think, that we're all looking for, especially now, you know, post-pandemic. It's like, I think it helps us really value what retail brings to the table. And retail is not just within luxury fashion. It's on so many different levels, you know? So I think, again, I want to debunk that idea that retail is dead. I think it's stronger than ever. And I think it's only going to get stronger with the help and support of technology as we move forward into the future. What three skills do you think are the most important to have when working in retail and fashion? First and foremost, I think you need to have passion. I think it's so important to be able to have passion about the industry, passion about fashion, passion about, you know, the industry of fashion. It is an incredible business. There is so much, you know, there is an incredible ecosystem that makes it happen. And I think you have to be able to want to give it all. I think it's also important to have a very strong point of view in fashion to be in this industry. It's important that you know what's happening. You're able to articulate your point of view, what you're thinking, the translation of fashion. And then, you know, it's super important to be able to be on it. Fashion changes daily, like second to second, minute to minute, hour to hour. It's like, you gotta be on it. You gotta know what's going on so you can stay ahead of it. What advice do you have for students or recent graduates as they begin their careers? It's so important to be clear in what it is that you're looking for. I think, you know, after graduation or as you're on your job search, really take the time to do your research, know what part of the industry you're looking to interview for, understand who does it best, who do you want to work for. I think that's incredibly important. I also encourage everyone to ask, you know, to connect with mentors, mentees, ask questions, ask for connections, really be able to see who can help you on your career path and journey. And I think, it's always interesting when I talk to future candidates and people who come for interviews, loving clothes is so much a part of why we're all in fashion, but it's so important to know how you can contribute to the fashion industry. So I encourage everyone to do some more homework on how you feel you can impact, you know, and make your mark in the fashion industry before walking into an interview. I've enjoyed answering 20 questions and sharing more about how I built my career. You can check out more insights with retail professionals at nrffoundation.org/allaccess. I'm Roopal Patel with Saks Fifth Avenue. Thanks for watching.